I want to share with you, when I was small, there was a little song that they sang, Just a Closer Walk with Thee. It used to be something that impressed me because I would like to walk closer to the Lord. I would like to have a relationship with Him that where it is good for me, where it is beneficial for Him and for me that we walk together. So Paul writes in Galatians 5:16, he says, walk in the Spirit, and you shall not fulfill the lusts of the flesh. So when you want to walk with God, and you want to experience that glory and that intimacy, you must walk in the Spirit. And so many people want to walk with God, but they can't just behave themselves. And they try to cling on what is here on earth and what makes them temporarily happy. Well, you know what? You can't do that. Paul writes specifically to the church because they must be taught how to walk in the Spirit and operate in His power and how to walk with God. Colossians 1:9, he says, from the day that we've heard, we've not ceased to pray for you, asking that you may be filled with the knowledge of God's will and in all spiritual wisdom and understanding, so as to walk in a manner worthy of the Lord, fully pleasing to Him, bearing fruit in every good work, and increasing in the knowledge of God. Because it's not a road that goes like this. It's a road where you need to increase and where you need to become more friendly with the Lord, where you need to learn how to behave if you want to walk with the King of the universe. So He knows from personal experience that the walk with the Lord allows us to get these benefits. Jesus called His disciples and us His friends, His children. So think of the friends in the Bible that God had, like Moses and Enoch, and people that He walked so closely with Him that it was an incredible thing that to even think that we have that through Jesus Christ, that we can have this personal, incredible relationship that is beneficial to us to grow. So in 1 Thessalonians 4:1, Paul writes, we ask and urge you in the Lord Jesus Christ that as you receive from us how you ought to walk and to please God, just as you are doing, that you do so more and more. To please God and to do everything to His glory. There's a scripture that says everything that we do must glorify God. It must be to honor God. So you can't grab hold of God and want to be personal with Him and also grab hold of the things of the world and want to hold on to them. It's not going to work for you. There's one man that impresses me tremendously, and it is Enoch. He's the seventh generation after Adam through his son Seth. In Genesis 5:21, it says, when Enoch was 65, he had a son named Methuselah. And he's the one who got to be 969 years old. And Enoch walked with God 300 years after he fathered the son, and he fathered other sons and daughters. And all the days of Enoch were 365, and Enoch walked with God, and he was not, for God took him away. So when you read in Hebrews 11:5, it says, by faith, Enoch was taken up so that he should not see death. And he was not found because God had taken him. Now, before he was taken, he was commended for having pleased God. Isn't that incredible that we can walk with God and please God to such a degree? How incredible is that? And he walked into glory with God as friends, on that level of friendship. What I want for myself is intimacy with the Lord, personal relationship. And I want to pursue that actively because many people want to walk with the Lord. They don't behave, and they do not want to sacrifice worldly pleasures and lusts and what they want for themselves, their ideals and their ideas. So let's seek the Lord. Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, that we can come to you in Jesus' name and always know that you are waiting to receive us and to walk with us as friends, and that we must still honor you in an incredible way, but that you want to grow the intimacy between us. Please help us in this way. In Jesus. Amen.